of focus on the ones that are weaker on him, which are his, you know, the muscles in the front of the shoulder to come to reach forward, and then sort of do his triceps, which are back here. Actually, he has pretty long arms. So.
And you can tell I didn't do any curls. Well, not from a while.
Okay. Anterior deltoid. No. Okay. I'm putting this mitt on him just to help him grip the handle better. Since his grip is a little on the weaker side, this just helps keep his hand on there. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna put the electrical stim up on every muscle that I put the electron on. So you just let me know if it's too much, too little. Okay, so let's start with the scapula right there. Like, how does it feel?
It's not bad right now.
I think that's all I need. Did you see? Did you feel it? Just okay. So I know it kicked in. Okay. So what's gonna happen is we do a warm up first. Okay. What happens first is the shoulder and your shoulder blade back here, the muscles back here.
Okay.
You'll feel those go on first. Those will stay on the whole time, and they're on for a few minutes. Because they really work to stabilize. You need to stabilize the shoulder before we actually get it moving. Then after that, when it says active therapy, and you'll feel it, like you can't mistake it, it'll say active therapy, that's when you're gonna start feeling these muscles start cycling with the E-stim, okay? Because it's gonna kind of stimulate you cycling, and that's when it kicks in. So the ones on the arm, which is this one in the back here, kind of cycle. The ones on top, right over your shoulder and in the shoulder blade, stay on the whole time to keep your shoulder nice and stable and in good form, okay? So you ready?
Yes.
All right, I'm gonna hit go. So this is the FES bike. I'm currently using it with Joe for his right arm. Basically, it targets certain muscles in his arm that we want to promote and improve movement and function. So right now I have it on his shoulder and on two of the muscles in his arm, which kind of one muscle helps him reach forward and the other muscle helps him straighten out his elbow. Those are two movements that Joe has some weaknesses in. So we're trying to target those. Later on, as we progress in this, we will use other or target other muscle groups. So right now, this is his first day, so we figured we'd give it a shot with his shoulders to stabilize his shoulder and shoulder blade and two of the muscles in his arm. You can use it for the legs, but I don't do the legs. I do most, you know, the arms. So we're doing, and in stroke, since usually it's one-sided, is one side of the body is affected. We usually use one arm, but on spinal cord, a lot of times it's likely that they'll be using both arms. But right for today, for Joe, it's his right arm since the stroke affected his right side of his body. And so far he's tolerating it really well. So if you fall under the control speed and resistance that I've set target speeds and target resistance. So if you fall under it, you'll probably feel a zing or some more E-stim because the machine is trying to get you to get to those target speeds and resistance. So it will actually send some more electrical stim to those muscles. Okay, so that's what you'll feel. And we use this as a form of muscle re-education, okay? Because the E-stim bypasses the brain, targets the muscle directly. But the more you move your arm, the more you retrain the brain.